Hi folks, we are on NH48 on the highway that connects Krishnagiri to Chennai, and we are headed towards Vellore today. It's a beautiful highway, beautiful roads. Now, a few years ago, if you were driving on this highway, there weren't too many places that you could stop at to get something to eat. And all that has changed now. So one of the restaurants that's hugely popular on this route is Hotel Sai Sangeet. And we are headed towards the Vaniyambadi outlet of Sai Sangeet today to catch some breakfast.
Sai Sangeet is much more than your typical highway eatery, with birds chirping around and an interesting store out front that sells everything from windchimes to clay pots and pans.
Mortar, pestle, they've got these wind chimes right here. You've got these pickle jars. They have these paniyaram pans on sale. You can fry these small, delicious paniyarams on this. I think it's made of iron. So they have these stone, they call it the ammi kallu here locally, to grind the masala. You've got the mortar and pestle. I think these are the grain grinders. So you put the grain here and then you turn it around and you grind it. Masala grinder, quite an interesting stop for breakfast, I must say.
You can pack some savories to sustain you on the drive. They've got a range of halwas here. So this is a karupati halwa. I think this is a black jaggery halwa. You also have some other halwas here. Milk halwa, badam halwa, cashew nut halwa and a milk date halwa. I think we will certainly try one or two of these halwas. Let's go in and eat some breakfast.
I must say it's nice and comfortable here, it's very cool. You know, there are these very interesting touches here, which is what's nice about Sai Sangeet. It's not just a functional sort of a highway pit stop. It has some charm, it has some personality. I think my idli vada is here.
Ragi Puri.
So I've got the idli, I've got the vada. Got a smattering of chutneys, which is what I always love about having idli vada in Tamil Nadu. So you've got the coconut chutney, you've got the onion tomato chutney, you've got the mint chutney, and you've got the podi. I think it's with some ghee. And this is what they call a vada curry. I've not eaten this before, but let's try it.
And of course, the thick, hearty Tamil sambar.
Oh, the idli is light and fluffy. You hold the idli like this and it wobbles. You know, it's a lovely idli. Let's taste some idli. I'm going to taste it first with the vada curry because I've not tasted the vada curry before. The idli has a tart flavor. It's light, it's fluffy, it has a tart edge. And the vada curry has the bite of the lentil intact. In fact, it's quite delicious.
You got some flecks of onion too.
Very good. Time to go for the chutney. The sweetness of the coconut,
the tart edge, the tartness of the idli, beautiful combination.
With the onion tomato chutney.
This one has a tangy edge to it. I want to taste some with the podi. I've never
tasted the idli with the podi.
This one gets you right at the throat.
We'll taste some sambar. You can feel the weight, all that nourishing lentil in the sambar. It's so thick, it's almost like a curry of sorts.
Let's taste the vada.
I love the way this vada is studded with peppercorn, chili. I think there's some curry leaves as well. Just the way vada should be. Crunchy on the outside,
and soft and porous within.
There's also some onion in this that I just tasted.
I think the
sweetness of the onion makes all that difference. You got the sweetness of the onion, you've got the heat from the peppercorn. This is one seriously delicious vada.
Let's dip the vada now in the sambar. So good. This is probably the tastiest vada that I've eaten. With some coconut chutney now.
So good. I've been sitting here for a while, so it's kind of
sunk in already. I think this is the only place where I've tasted a ragi puri. Let's taste the ragi puri just by itself. You can feel the bite of the ragi in the puri. It's definitely not as light as your wheat puri, but it is very filling, it is very nourishing as you taste it. Sagu, potato. I think the potato is gently spiced. You got the potato, you got the spices, you got some chili. This certainly is a filling puri. I think you have two of these. All that wholesomeness of the ragi will ensure that you have your tummy full at least for the next couple of hours. I think typically when you talk about puri, you know, it's an indulgence with the fact that the puri is deep fried. But when you're having it with ragi, well, it's a wholesome sort of an indulgence. Now this is something else that I have not tasted before. This is the podi uthappam, and I've heard this is a speciality here. So you've got these mini uthappams on which you have podi that is smeared. Podi is basically lentils and some spice. And this is going to be spicy too. Oh, this is beautiful. You can see all that podi that is smeared on the uthappam. In fact, the podi is completely covering the uthappam. So when you taste it, you got the soft, fluffy texture of the dosa and the crunch of the podi. The lentils, the spices, quite delicious. Taste it with the chutney. The chutney rounds off all the flavors. So you got a soft, fluffy dosa, you got that spice, that crunch from the podi, and then you've got the subtle sweetness of the coconut in the chutney. Beautiful. These look so interesting that I had to take that picture. The two halwas that I'm ending breakfast with.
This is called the Karupati halwa. Apparently it's made of black jaggery, some milk, and I'm also told there's some wheat in this.
And then we have here the date and milk halwa. So I can see some flecks of date in this.
I think I'm going to taste the
date and milk halwa first, because I think that seems to be more
intense in its flavor. At least that's what I think.
Let's taste this. The milk and date halwa. You can taste the milk. The milk solid is actually the khova, dates. And there's a lot of ghee that's gone into it. What's nice is that it's not too sweet. It's quite nice. You're going to taste the Karupati halwa. The Karupati or Karupati halwa, I'm not sure. This one's made of black jaggery.
You got the intense flavor of the jaggery. You got the toasted cashew. So you got that toasty sort of a flavor, and then you have that sticky texture, maybe of the wheat that's gone into the halwa to kind of bring it all together. And then of course there's a copious amount of ghee that you can see glistening right here. But I think if you order one of this, you probably need to have four people on the table to finish that, because that's a rich halwa. On the other hand, the milk and date halwa is not so rich and something that I can finish entirely on my own. After the decadent indulgence of the halwas, this is what you need, a coffee to settle everything down. As expected, the coffee is nice, thick and strong. There's birds here, I don't know what birds. There's also some, I think they're guinea pigs.
some pigeons.
It's also perfect if you're on the road with family, with children. Great place to entertain them, especially if they've been cranky on the road.
Sai Sangeet is much more than any eatery on the highway. With its charming, folksy decor, the lovely store that you have here, it creates quite a welcoming sort of an ambience. And the food tastes wholesome and delicious. And in a lovely, idyllic setting like this. If you're on the highway in this part of the country, a stop at Sai Sangeet is just the refreshing break that you need to recharge, refresh, and proceed on your journey ahead. Happy eating and stay safe.
If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to share and leave a comment. Do subscribe and stay tuned to Food Lovers TV for more episodes from Gourmet on the Road.